run for a long period of time in that throughout her career as well. Which she lost in the round of 16. A relative lead at number 7 in the women's singles for this event. Hasn't progressed too far, but is a young player. Progressed through the under 20. Ding leading 5-4 in this opening game. The back of the court picking up the balls, umpires throwing the balls. So the play is literally...
us touching the top of the net on the way over for that serve.
Game point here and takes it 11-7 in the first game. Let's see what she can do differently in this game here.
Nicely.
Going back to 2008 on this occasion. Because otherwise, I think none of these players have been playing prior to 2008. Yeah, Ding's really strong on that pivot. Doesn't miss too many at all. Running away with a 7-1 lead in the second game. 9-3 lead at the moment.
Oh, he won from Korea. And then Miu Hirano.
7-1. Meters, or in the old terms, 5'7". Same height as my offsider, Alois Rosario.
Head, yeah. Forehand and backhand.
Yeah, very effortless, the way that she's moving around the court. Oh, that was a very good smash there from... good shot there. Was involved in a little bit of controversy in the London Olympic Games. There's that backhand serve.
There's that famous serve of Ding Ning.
That was the serve that was a little bit controversial. Let's see the service here. It looked like it went
5-9.
That was a good shot there from Cheng.
No mean feat, and that's where Cheng is right now, but she's up against one of the greatest. Tableton has played in every country of the world, affiliated with the ITTF, and there's Ding Ning taking the third Australian Open.
Good shot there.
Is fighting for a place in the last 16 against Soo Hyo Won from Republic of Korea.
Club she belongs to is Beijing Shugang.
Oh.
True. Oh, that's round of 32 match. And there we have it. Ding running away the winner.